Welcome to the Metals Daily News, brought to you by Metals Update, the driving force behind your business. I am Neha Kamle from the Mumbai office on 5th of June 2017. 3-month copper forwards traded on LME continued to fall further on Monday by 1% following a loss of 0.6% on Friday. Weakness in copper prices was on account of weak Chinese demand, increase in the US interest rates and hedge fund managers reducing long position in the market. China's decision to delay an 8% quota for electric and hybrid vehicles by a year until 2019 can affect the demand for copper. China's fixed asset investment data for April was lower than expected, while the car sales witnessed the biggest yearly fall since August 2015. All these factors indicate the copper demand in China is decreasing and copper and copper mining stocks will move to the lower price levels. The only glimmer of hope for the bulls in the market is from the ongoing strike at the Grasberg copper mine, which is likely to cause reduction in supply of copper. The company had earlier released a statement that mining and milling rates were adversely affected due to ongoing strike. After a pleasant report from US ADP showing addition to private jobs in US, the all-crucial non-farm payroll report disappointed the markets. The non-farm payroll report stated that 1,38,000 jobs were added in the US non-farm sector during the month of May as compared to the market expectation of an addition of 1,85,000 jobs. The US dollar index moved to fresh lows on Friday post the release of the report and settled at 96.61, representing a fall of 0.57%. Risk aversion on account of terror attacks at London has caused the greenback to trade higher by 0.12% at 96.72 in early European trade. Probability for a June rate hike by the US Fed has increased to 95% today as compared to 91% on Friday. Hindalco Industries Limited will be supplying high-end aluminium alloy plate to India's defense industry. The $307 million plan will be completed by 2019 under a public-private partnership. India will require 5,000 metric tons of high-end aluminium alloy plates by 2021, which will be supplied by Hindalco Industries Limited. The state-owned National Aluminium Company Limited, NALCO, has recently begun the process of opening a new mine at Panchpatmali, Orissa. NALCO will now be in position to maintain its current bauxite production of 6.8 million tons per annum. Metals Update assessed offers for MS scrap from Mandi Govindgarh market at ₹21,100 per ton, while fresh scrap is being offered at ₹23,500 per ton. Offers of MS ingots at Mandi Govindgarh are currently quoted at ₹28,500 per ton, while at Ludhiana and Muzaffarnagar the offers have been recorded at ₹28,900 and ₹26,600 per ton respectively. It is expected that stockists will not be purchasing fresh stock until the implementation of GST, which will cause prices to remain range bound. In the Kolkata and Raipur markets, however, prices in iron and steel increased today on account of shortage of raw material leading to stockists buying. MS ingots were being offered at ₹24,000 per ton at Kolkata, while at Raipur the offers were at ₹24,600 per ton. Offers for sponge iron at Kolkata are at ₹16,000 per ton, while at Raipur they are at ₹15,600 per ton. In international offers, aluminium scrap 6063 of purity 99.99% of Chinese origin is being offered at $1,220 per ton on CIF basis CFR China. Also, the copper billets of purity ranging from 99.51 to 99.61 is available at $5,495.05 per ton on CIF Nava Sheva. The iron wire rope scrap of Korean origin is available at $895 a metric ton CIF Nava Sheva. Thank you for listening. Join me again tomorrow for the latest updates from the metals market. Visit metalsupdate.com for more information and do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.